The orienting response, OR, also called the orienting reflex, is an organism's immediate response to a change in its environment when that change is not sudden enough to elicit the startle reflex. One salient characteristic of the orienting reflex is that it habituates, i.e., the subject stops responding to the stimulus over repeated presentations. Habituation has been generally defined as a decrease in responding after repeated stimulations. This habituation is when attention is redirected to the stimulus after there has been a change in the nature of the stimulus. For example, you may orient to the sound of the clothes dryer when it is first turned on. Very shortly, you habituate and you are no longer aware of the sound. But suppose a coin falls out of a pocket as the dryer is running. Now the sound of the dryer has changed and you dishabituate and you orient. If you are intensely interested in what is causing this new noise, you will take longer to habituate to the new sound. The orienting reflex, first introduced into modern psychology by Pavlov in 1910 and made popular more recently by Sokolov in 1963, has been defined in the broad sense as a series of reactions bringing the organism into contact with the objects and tuning the analyzers of the organism so that perception of the stimulus takes place in the most favorable conditions. According to theorists, the orienting reflex differs from other behaviors, such as exploratory behavior, in that it is not involved in the elaboration or perception of the stimulus, but only in the tuning or focusing of the organism's analyzers to be able to perceive or elaborate. Thus, the orienting reflex occurs temporarily prior to any behavior associated with elaboration. It is possible, therefore, for an organism to exhibit an orienting reflex and no further elaboration or perception. But it is not possible to elaborate without first having exhibited an orienting reflex. Automatic orienting to unexpected changes in the environment is a prerequisite for adaptive behavior. Despite the fundamental significance of the OR in everyday life, only little is known about how the OR is affected by healthy aging. The orienting reflex allows for flexible adaptive behavior to sudden and presumably unexpected changes in the environment, which indicate a potentially relevant or even dangerous situation. This implies that sensory change detection underlying the OR is an automatic, pre-attentive process. From a subjective point of view, the OR is perceived as a disruption of the current attentional focus, example, to a task at hand or a current goal. This involuntary attention switching is a feature that the orienting reflex shares with other mechanisms of automatic change detection. The detection of stimuli deviating from a continuous sensory auditory, i.e., auditory oddball simulation. The orienting reflex, however, also compromises autonomic, physiological and motor effects. The typical OR increase is the level and triggers in the bodily orientation to the source of the detected change. Human emotions are considered here to be founded on motivational circuits in the brain that evolved to protect, defensive, and to sustain, appetitive, for the whole life of the individuals and species. These circuits are phylogenetically old, shared among mammals, and involve the activation of both subcortical and cortical structures that mediate attention, perception, and action. Circuit activation begins a feature match between a cue and an existing representation in memory that has motivational significance. Subsequent process includes rapid cue-directed orienting, information gathering, and action selection. What is it, where is it, and what to do? Studies of emotional perception measure that index orienting to emotional cues generally show enhanced circuit activation and response facilitation relative to orienting indicators occasioned by the effectively neutral cues that are presented concurrently or independently. What psychology professors often fail to include or simply don't know is that under certain special circumstances, OR effect does not occur. When a third party attended Pavlov's experiments, the salivating effect was actually absent. The sudden presence of the observer hijacked the dog's attention, overriding the powerful effect of conditioning. What is true for dogs in this case is true for humans as well. Principles like these can be extremely valuable. A vast amount of useful neuroscientific research is done, yet capturing attention, guiding attention, and retaining attention is not really used to its fullest potential by educators and even marketers. In the dogs, the investigatory reflex only affects the senses, the ringing of the bell. Yet the orienting response in humans affects more blood pressure, heart rate, and respiration, reacting to the orienting response. The use of brain imaging technologies, specific brain waves are identified that correspond with the shifts in the attention. These brain waves are known as the O waves. Neuroscientists were able to identify the stimuli that produces the most powerful shifts in attention. With this knowledge on their side, it was only a matter of time how this stimuli was applied in marketing and sales. Using strategically placed cuts in commercials instigates a powerful orienting response, guiding attention to the desired message, as is the case with most principles in applied neuropsychology. Improper implementation can trigger the exact opposite of the intended behavior. This concept is known as psychological backfiring. Following the development in the neuroscience of attention, the average frequency of cuts in advertisements increased by more than 50%, but more is not always better. Due to the excessive amounts of cuts, the viewer's attention is continuously drawn away, therefore attention scatters instead of focuses, and customers are unable to understand the intended message. When redirecting and capturing your audience's attention, attention cues should be used sparsely and placed correctly. In comparison today to the predecessors, modern-day consumers are relatively desensitized to when it comes to the attention cues. Orienting response could indicate a life or death situation to our ancestors, but nowadays we know that cuts in commercial breaks won't kill us. Therefore, we pay less attention when spammed. To effectively reach your audience, you should place the cut that orients your audience's attention just before you deliver the main point in your video or a commercial. All our sensory inputs is processed relative to previous experience. Contrasting works on all domains of perception. This contrasting effect takes place whenever the enhancement or a reduction of an observed stimuli is compared with the contrasting object, prices, products, and even the partners we choose are all susceptible to these effects. But since we are so often exposed to contrast, the concept is more likely to backfire when applied poorly. When contrasts are overused, the overall attention of the audience may increase. However, they won't be able to focus or remember due to overstimulation. Subtlety is key here. Guiding attention can be extremely powerful, and it has been with humans ever since the dawn of time. The ability to focus and shift attention was necessary to help us survive and evolve. Today, it has become the ultimate trophy for each marketer. By applying insight and psychology and neuroscience, attention can be guided, but it is not that easy. Improper implementation could result in reverse outcomes. With the ongoing contest for attention, one thing is certain: attention is becoming increasingly rare. So when you have someone's attention, make it count. Whether you're a marketer, lecturer, or a storyteller, your message should be authentic, consistent, and entertaining.